Hey everybody, welcome back to the very first inaugural video. Well, I wouldn't even say it's my first review, but it's the first ever in a series called Better Late Than Never. That's where I take a video game and I review it after beating it completely, and the review comes out usually late. But hey, it's better to get it late than never, right? So here's what we're gonna do. The first video in this series is actually a little game called Scarf. Now, Scarf is developed by Uprising Studios and published by Handy Games, and it is a 3D platformer puzzle-like adventure game. Now, at the moment, Scarf is not on any console, but it is on PC and also Mac OS, but who plays games on a Mac? Anyways, let's talk about the game itself. Now, the reviews break down in very specific ways. First, talk about the game, then talk about its performance, then graphics, story, gameplay, and then my final synopsis, and then you get my score after that. So let's talk about Scarf. Now, for the sake of transparency though, I was given a key for this game, so I just want to let you guys know about that before we go into the review. Now, Scarf is a little bit weird. I shouldn't say weird. If you've played games like, let's say, ICO or Journey, you may get some vibes from that specifically. And the reason why I say that is because there is actually no combat at all, basically. The entire game is you just solving puzzles, going through the actual world, trying to figure things out and move along the story and the plot. I did finish this game in about 4 to 5 hours. It didn't take far too long, actually. I did somewhat enjoy what I played, but I think there are some other things that really bring up that attention of that game specifically and what may actually hinder it from having a better score. Let's talk about performance. The version 1.0 that I played was not very good. In fact, there were a lot of issues with frame rate, frame time, and even stuttering. The graphics options menus in the game for PC were not very well tuned, and even then they didn't have a lot of options available to you to actually adjust the graphics settings. Mostly things from low, medium, and high, and even at 1440p resolution, I got a lot of really strange frame drops. I barely ever broke 60 FPS on high, and although this game with a pretty art style does look good, it doesn't really seem to be the thing that will push my GPU to the limit or lock me behind a frame rate. On top of that, there were many instances in the world, especially when you're going underwater, that caused massive frame rate drops and or frame time issues, causing you to have severe lag and things like that. Although not too often in the game, they were apparent enough, and I really think that is a major factor for the game, especially people trying to play games on lower end systems. An indie game like this really shouldn't have any of those problems, but unfortunately, they are there. Having a smooth experience is always important for me, and making sure that it can run on different types of hardware and have the options that you need to either uptune or downscale certain games is really important too. So just be aware if you're gonna check this out in the first place. There are performance issues and there are performance options that aren't there or very limited. Now let's talk about gameplay. Gameplay, this game is definitely a let's smoke a bowl, chill out, and enjoy this time while we have together. The music is pretty good. It's also piano and stringy and things like that. It does try to elicit quite a few emotions while you play the game. You know, the whole David Cage bit, but I'm not going to make that joke here. The thing is, though, the gameplay is very basic. A lot of it is just push block puzzles, solving puzzles here and there, trying to get around an actual world or environment, solving for specific things, and then moving on to the next zone. There's really nothing super intuitive. In fact, I'd say the first two zones are very easy, while the third and fourth zone pick up in difficulty randomly out of nowhere, but it's nothing too difficult that really you couldn't figure out after just a few minutes of looking at it, depending upon how hard you hit the bong though. And that's pretty much what I liked about this game specifically. The fact that this is more a sort of like chill, relax, sit back and sort of like engulf yourself in kind of game. There's no health bar, there's no enemies, well, none that are actually there. And then most of the time, your only risk that you have is in fact just falling to your death, but you're gonna be respawned shortly after with no loss of life or even no lives lost. So you're pretty much just gonna be hanging around trying to solve these puzzles in this pretty cool looking world. Now, you don't just solve puzzles in the gameplay. You do have specific mechanics that the scarf does in fact give you. You can do a double jump, which I think is actually necessary because the beginning jump of that game is not that great. It's kind of low and a little bit too floaty for me. It doesn't feel really well in the first place. You also have a hook, which can give you the ability to swing from point to point if you need to. And then you can also have a glider, which will let you glide a pretty good amount across the map, by the way, which will get you from point to point a lot faster across large crevices. The puzzles, however, are pretty easy, and they don't really take a lot of brain power. So, like I said before, it's a pretty chill game, but if that's what you're looking for, then it's up your alley. However, if you want something a little bit more interactive, this may not be for you. Let's talk about the visuals. They're okay. I mean, you're not going to be looking at something like Horizon Forbidden West or anything that's going to be blowing your socks off, but it has a great art style. It's almost like cel shaded, but not. It's got a real cool look to it, and sometimes you do in fact get a pretty cool little vista. However, though, like I said before, the vistas and the world do get marred by frame rate and frame time issues. It's nothing terrible to look at, it's nothing grandiose to look at, but it's your typical indie platforming adventure game that has that style of graphics that tries to elicit something out of you, the player. So with most indie games, what you're looking for is something that has a phenomenal story, especially a game like this. Really what you're trying to see is, even though the visuals may not be the best, the music is pretty good, and the gameplay can be pretty average, what is going to carry me through this game the most? And it's usually the plot or the story. That's really what carries a lot of video games like these forward. However, though, the story... Wow. Now, hold on. That's not to say that the story is actually bad. The thing is, it's just pretty basic. You pretty much figure out what's going on in the story, I'd say, within the first hour and a half of playing the game. I'm not going to spoil it here, but it's pretty apparent what's going on. You realize it when things are going around a specific way. But just to give you a quick synopsis, you are born out of this thing, and then you go around trying to recapture pieces of cloth that were ripped apart from the mother that bore you. And of course, that mother is an extraterrestrial dragon thing that gives powers to people who wear those pieces of cloth. Now, during that time, right at the beginning, you find out that there is another creature that is almost like a dragon-shaped kind of thing. It becomes your pet, basically. You become friends with it. And then as you progress through the story, you either feed it to get its health back in certain situations. It becomes part of you. It gives you specific abilities that you can use throughout the game. And then you try to create a bond or connection with that. But then as you continue to play through the story, you get to see other moments as well about the nomads that have taken parts of this cloth from the mother that bore you, basically, and are using them for their own will. Now, of course, the gate that your mother has created with her body, basically, is now torn apart. You're using those pieces of cloth to build that gate back together to get back to her. So even with all these things together, Scarf isn't a bad game, but it's not a great game to play either. But it is reasonably priced at $14.99 right now on Steam. With that all being said, though, put together with time played, what the game offers, and of course the price, I think Scarf is a 3 out of 5. Anyways, everyone, let me know what you guys think about today's review. Let me know what you guys are going to pick up Scarf in general, what you guys plan on doing with it as well, and what other games you want me to review that will be better late than never. Now, every game is open for review, so I'd like to definitely have your opinion on that as well. And if you want to subscribe to the channel, please do so. We're hitting 18K very closely. And if you want to join the Discord, the link to that is in the description down below. You can follow me on Twitch and Twitter as well. Anyways, y'all, thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate everything. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you next time.